Foreshadowing the Year of the Feminine, November 2017. Emmanuel Dagher. A message from Emmanuel Dagher. Wednesday, 1st of November, 2017. Webpage, www.emmanueldagher.com. My friend. There's so much for us to catch up on, so let's get right to it. A foreshadowing of the return of the divine feminine. In October, we began to see the next level of awakening taking place in the hearts and minds of humanity. This awakening is directly linked to the influx of the divine feminine energies being activated within the consciousness of each person on the planet, preparing us for the new shifts coming in 2018 and beyond. The foundations for us to receive the next wave of awakening into the divine feminine will continue to build and strengthen throughout November. Strengthening our intuition. One of the many gifts the divine feminine offers us is the gift of intuition. Our intuition works closely with the right hemisphere of the brain, offering us insights that bypass the confines of logic and reason. It's a natural inner knowing that transcends mental intellect and connects us to the wisdom of the heart. Intuition is the voice of our spirit. Our intuition speaks to us constantly, whether the mind chooses to listen to it or even be aware of it or not. It is always guiding us in the direction of our highest path and nudging us toward greater expansion so that we can live the greatest version of our life in this third dimensional reality. In November, we will be given the opportunity to connect more deeply with our intuition. This can come in many different ways. The only thing asked of us is that we pay attention to and live in the present moment as much as we can. This will ensure that our connection to our intuition is strengthened significantly so that we will be ready for the next phase of our personal and collective awakening. By connecting with our intuition, we empower our lives to flow with greater ease. The more aligned we are with that higher flow, the more aligned we are to creating a life of fulfillment, joy, love, peace, prosperity, freedom, and well-being. The illusion is dissolving. For eons, collective society has predominantly operated on survival-driven patriarchal principles. These have come to us through institutions that have promoted fear and separation, delivered in the forms of religion, war, education, government, entertainment, and medicine. During this time, the more nurturing, intuitive, and creative principles of the divine feminine, such as valuing the individual, honoring the earth, and seeking natural healing and personal growth, were shoved to the side as being too passive, heart-based, and non-productive. Humanity lived with this imbalance for thousands of years. Yet it was all a part of a soul contract we all made to use that imbalance to learn lessons, heal, evolve, and come back to the truth of who we are at our core. It's important to thank and honor all of the patriarchal institutions that promoted fear and separation, as challenging as that may be, because they played a pivotal part in our awakening process. They signed up to play the role of the challenger on our journey so that we could see the contrast between what we wanted to create more of in our lives, and what we did not want more of. The moment we are able to thank and honor all of the challenges in our lives, no matter how hard they seem at the time, is the moment we free ourselves from the power they have held over us. This is what is happening now. People are waking up and freeing themselves from the illusion of fear and separation. We are taking their power back. This movement is dissolving the old survival-based patriarchal system, as the more matriarchal values of heart-based, soul-directed living come to the front of our consciousness. We can clearly see the dissolving of the old system happening all around the world. Systems and ideologies operating by way of fear tactics, control, greed, and secrecy, without integrity, will not be able to continue on much longer. The chaos and seeming amplification of fear we have been seeing lately is actually a clear confirmation that humanity as a whole has had enough, and that we are ready for something very different. If things are looking a little scarier to you in the world, it's because there is a desperation being felt right now by those trying to cause the fear. The way I view it is that it's the ego part of humanity, just the mind trying to protect itself and keep things the same. With this awareness, we can have compassion, without having to buy our feet into the fear tactics. The awakening process was called forth by our spirit long before we even entered this paradigm. So we can take comfort in knowing that there's no right or wrong when it comes to how we move through our awakening. Our intuition will always find a way to guide us back to our true selves, whether we choose to take the longer scenic route or a more direct one, the next phase of awakening. This new phase of our awakening, which began in October, is supporting us in moving past the role of the victim. We now have the opportunity to retire the victim archetype that we and our ancestors have identified with over many lifetimes. Before we retire the victim archetype, it's important to honor it for serving to keep us safe and protected in a world that used to operate purely on survival. It's also important that we give our experiences of identifying with victim consciousness their full dignity and right to be seen, heard, and acknowledged. This is actually the first step toward freeing ourselves from continuing to remain in the role of the victim. We never want to sugarcoat, get rid of, blame, or deny anything that we experienced during those times that we identified with being a victim. The second step in releasing victim consciousness is to accept every person, experience, and thing as it has shown up in our lives, without trying to change it. By accepting these things, we are not saying that we resonate, approve of, or agree with them. We are simply giving ourselves permission to not allow them to define us. The third step in releasing victim consciousness is to let go of blame, in other words, forgiveness. Blame comes from a need to make something or someone else right, wrong or good, bad, and somehow responsible for what we have experienced. At our core, we are the creator of all of our experiences. When we consciously operate from our creator self, we transcend duality. We move from judgment into discernment. As we step into the beauty and power of our creator self, we navigate our way forward by choosing only what feels to be in alignment for us, and releasing what doesn't. We understand that just because something does or does not resonate with us doesn't mean it is good or bad, or someone else's decision for us, or vice versa. Can you feel how much lighter it is to operate from that space? There is only resonance or no resonance. Meaning, I choose more of this, or I choose less or none of this. There is no need for good or bad labels anymore. This is freedom. The fourth step in moving past victim consciousness is to reclaim our power. Reclaiming our power means we are committed to connecting with who we are at our core. We do this through self-love, care, kindness, nourishment, spiritual development, and creative expression. The most powerful people on the planet are not the ones who control or belittle others. The most powerful people on the planet are the ones who know who they truly are. They know that they are far greater than the sum of all of their experiences and stories. They know how to express themselves fully and to speak up from a place of love, without having to prove anything to anyone. They forgive quickly, and move past challenging experiences with greater ease. They are kind and loving to the world around them, and care for the well-being of all living things. They make a difference on the planet, without worrying how small or large the effect of that may be. They see past race, gender, religion, and sexual orientation. They root for and celebrate others' ability to thrive. They see themselves as part of a whole, rather than as being separate from all other forms of life. They know how to love, and how to be open and vulnerable. They are positive and optimistic. They stand up for what they believe in. And so much more. Just a small glimpse of the divine feminine, the insights shared in this forecast are just a small glimpse of what's coming with the next wave of awakening through the divine feminine. It's going to be so powerful. In December, the divine feminine will be here in her full glory, to usher us into 2018, the year of the divine feminine. I'm excited to share so much more of what this means for us in the coming months. For now, we can let ourselves receive and digest this current phase of awakening so that we are ready for all the magic soon coming our way. Until next time, miraculously yours, Emmanuel, 2009-2017 Emmanuel Dagher, Magnified Manifesting. All rights reserved. www.emmanueldagher.com. You are absolutely welcome to share and distribute these forecasts with others as you feel guided. Please make sure to keep the integrity of this article by including the author and source website link.